pathological determinants. Excellent. Till then we started with indicators of health. That means what factors indicate that you are in a good healthy condition. Before I go on, continue that, can anyone tell me the definition of health correctly?
State of complete physical, mental,
again, in ICU, even if they were admitted, how many days were they dependent on oxygen? Or how many days were they dependent on high flow oxygen? Okay, all these things depend on what? The severity of the disease, isn't it? For example, now she's coughing, Rishita is coughing. Okay, so if she is coughing, what does that indicate? Fine, that indicates physically she is not normal. Okay, but how severe is it? Whether she is okay, her coughing episodes are not many, okay, and then she is okay with the continuing with her daily activities, or she wants to take off from the college, and depends again how many days off she wants, whether she is on any medication, whether she
nourishment.
Okay, so do you know those? some which says what is their body fat, as in visceral fat. You have seen that. Have you all checked yours? How much of body percentage of water is there? Okay. What a percentage is the body? How much of muscle mass? All these things they tell you. Okay. So that shows someone who is very tall, very fat, doesn't say they're a bit malnourished. Okay. The nourishment is of course poor because that is fat, not muscle. Understand? Someone who is very fat, it might be more of fat, more than muscle. Understand? So nourishment is always muscle mass. Okay. How do you check for nourishment? There are a few things. Anthropometric measurements. Nutritional status means you have to check all these things. If you really want to say a person is well-nourished or well-built or whatever it is, so you need to check all these actually. Height and weight and BMI gives only your physical. Okay. And then anthropometric measurement. Anthropometric measurements in general is usually the head circumference. Have you seen when the babies are born? Anytime your relatives. So first thing they do is they measure the head circumference. Okay. In babies or kids it is usually head circumference. And then your mid-arm circumference. Okay, upper arm circumference. Then is this. Okay. The waist circumference. It's not circumference. When you something get as some caliper, it holds like this. The skin, the fat is held like that. Okay. More the fat, the worse the nourishment. Okay. So these are the nutritional indicators. If you really want to check, you should check like this. Otherwise, just go for BMI. Next is height and weight in school children. That is very commonly checked as a nutritional assessment in kids. Height and weight. Okay. Then is prevalence of low birth weight. Low birth weight is very common. Even now in, during pregnancy, the mom will be eating very nicely. Mom will be very hatta. She will be good, well built. But nourishment again, because you don't know if eating, they will be eating pizza, they will be eating burgers, and they will be eating all types of junk foods because it is allowed during pregnancy. Okay. So nourishment is always down. So though the height and weight of the mother is quite good, the baby weight is only this much. Okay. So the low birth weight prevalence is very high in India. Of late probably it's improved, but before it was really less. So today's homework, all of you go ask your mom what was your birth weight. You get to know. Not everywhere will be more than 2.5. Sorry. That is around 2.5. That is standard weight for Indian kids. Okay. Now, healthcare delivery indicators. That means how far, how good is the healthcare delivery system and also the utilization. So here we are talking about healthcare delivery. That means doctor population ratio. In Bangalore, I think doctors are more than the general population. Okay, so doctor population ratio, then doctor nurse ratio, which I agree nurses are actually less compared to doctors. Next is population bed ratio. That means for these many population, there has to be these number of beds. See, these things, they are not applicable in your urban areas, but definitely applicable in your rural areas. Okay, rural areas don't have so many medical facilities. Even now, few rural areas are there. There was a student, our student, she was saying, even now her place, in northeast, her place doesn't have proper electricity. So then forget the healthcare services that you don't even have